Since last week on 27th October, when Entebbe International Airport started enforcing mandatory COVID-19 tests to all passengers who come into the country done by the government, the airport has been a theatre of mess as some travellers allegedly had to wait for beyond 24 hours to get their COVID-19 results before they can proceed. Appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Trade, tour operators asked government to test the mandatory COVID-19 tests for tourists who are fully vaccinated and tested 72 hours before arrival.
Our plea as an industry right now is that people are arriving late and are already tired, they have issues, they have big, you know, it's also inconveniencing for many of the clients. Supervision can tell you, I think those who are older, those with families, climbing up ladders. But the sitting and waiting for the results is one very big challenge. For us as a country, as an industry, I would request that people that have done COVID jabs and have done testing 72 hours before they come to the country should be let through.
It's not true that a white person is a tourist. I have people in this country from Kenya who have been in for 4 days and they came in as tourists. So it is not true. But you need to understand that as private sector players, when they say mandatory testing, and you know that that mandatory testing is going to close your business for the next 1 year, you wake up and find solutions to your problems.
Amos Wekesa, a tour operator, told the committee that Uganda has started losing tourists who can't bear the harassment and inconvenience at Entebbe Airport, yet the tourism sector was just starting to recover from the pandemic restriction.
The guy arrives in the night at, maybe with Ethiopian Airlines, at 3 a.m. First of all, for them to get tested could take another, to get a swab would take about an hour, maybe 1.5 hours, some people is different. And then the person, if probably is not well registered, the person sits there for another 2 to 3 hours. And you know what it means with fatigue, the connection through the airport.
Two operators are concerned that Uganda is not making sense of COVID-19 vaccination since vaccinated tourists are not given preferential treatment. They want mandatory COVID-19 tests to be a reserve of the unvaccinated travelers.
There was a desire that we should treat an American tourist better than a Ugandan who is traveling. If I'm a Ugandan and I'm traveling from place A and I'm going to place B and I'm going to spend over 24 hours and less than a year and I don't have a job where I am going, I am called a tourist as well.
The other day I saw a Minister of Health saying things had changed and that now you'll get your results instantly and that they will even find you at the hotel, they will even, you know, online. But now we are getting different information.
Engineer Ayub Soma, the director of airports and security, told the committee that the confusion at the airport was caused by some delays of results on the first day of implementation because the facility for mandatory testing has not been fully established.
We really need to understand that this came at a short notice. We were given almost like 5 days. 5 days could not work. You know, you are putting up, as she rightly said, you are putting up construction. You have to draw up a floor plan for the people. You have to set up the laboratories. You have to set them. You have to make a dry run. You have to make a wet run. Honorable Chair, members of Parliament, it was not easy.
The Civil Aviation Authority official also noted that whereas testing of fully vaccinated passengers is being challenged globally by aviation industry as the fully vaccinated passengers are exempted from COVID-19 testing, Uganda government has not okayed the move.
The rationale, therefore, of testing the fully vaccinated is being challenged by many of the airport users. And that's why when I was telling you that now the move of the International Civil Aviation Organization, the move of the International Air Transport Association, the move for Airport Council International, where we are a member state, they are saying that for the industry to recover, the fully vaccinated should be eased to travel.
I am hearing a lot of talking about CAA, spokesperson of CAA. This is not a CAA matter, Honorable Chair. It is important to distinguish the mandates of these government agencies. I can even see people are almost angry about at CAA. Please save CAA.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.